Hello, it's Nick here again from Exam.net with a video on power user tips for those of you that have got to know the platform and would like to get even more out of Exam.net. Let's start by going through how to conduct a test or an assignment over several sessions, meaning that a student can start a test in one session and pick up and finish it later. Because students don't have accounts with Exam.net, you might think that this is impossible, but it can be done. Here's how it works. Students do the exam as usual in the first session and submit as if they've finished at the end of that session. When a student wants to continue at a later time with their exam or assignment, they need to use a special exam key. Each student has a unique key. You can find these unique keys by clicking on the button Individual Exam Keys to resume the exam. Here you can see a unique exam key associated with each student, which can then be emailed to them individually. This can, of course, be time-consuming for you to do for so many students, so I always require their email addresses as a separate field when I set up my exams. If you've done that, then there's a quick way to email all students their unique exam key in one go, which I'll show you now. The individual exam keys are valid for single use only, and they are found here in the Monitoring and Results view. Note that you can repeat this process over several sessions. Okay, so to make this as smooth as possible, you make sure to include emails in the student information section when you create the exam. In that way, each student will be required to provide their email address before starting the exam. Now you can use this list of email addresses to automatically distribute the correct exam key to the correct student. So, when it's time for your students to continue, you simply click here to send each student the information they need to continue where they left off. If you would like, as I often do, to set an assignment to complete at home so that the students can pick up whenever they like until they hand in, then if you make sure you turn off cheat protection completely in the exam settings, then the individual exam key can be used as many times as the student wishes at home. Just make sure that if you have a hand-in deadline, then you close the exam. Note that if you want them to work in class time over several sessions with no cheat protection, then by closing the exam between each session, you can ensure that they are not able to access it from home. As a math teacher, I sometimes use Desmos or GeoGebra as a tool for the students to work with in the classroom. You and your students can use the website address exam.net/practice without any keys or logins, and all exam.net tools are then available. But note here that any material created is not saved. If you want them to practice with those tools and have their work saved, you can create an exam like this, and then students can enter a dummy exam with the exam key and their information will be saved. Now I want to show you a great power user function. Let's say I want to create a geography test, and for whatever reason, I don't want to have it auto-marked. Instead, when I create the questions, I select Write Exam Questions, and I write my questions in the editor. Now, to the student, this exam will look like this. The student will see the questions here and write their answers in the writing area. Let's go back to when I created the exam. At the bottom of the editor, you see a drop-down menu. By default, this is set to only present the questions to the student, but you can change this to also add the questions into the student writing area. If I select this second option and save, the student will see this. As you can see, the questions are now also visible in the student's writing area, so the student is now able to write their answers below each question. Please note though that all text in the student's writing area can be edited by the student, including the questions in this case. Related to this feature is the Define Answer Format function. Let's say I created the geography test as before, but I chose the default setting and did not include the exam questions in the student writing area. Later in the process, down here in the student workspace section, you find an option to define answer format. If you click on this, you get a blank sheet to edit. Now, anything you write in this blank sheet will appear in the student's writing area. Before, I only had the option to include the complete exam or to have the student's writing area completely blank. But when I use the Define Answer Format, I can include any information I like. For example, as a math teacher, I could include a coordinate system under one question and a table under another, and the students could make use of these when answering the questions. Or, as I know some of my colleagues do, I could simply include the question numbers here, nothing else, to help the students organise their answers so that you can find them at the end. If I do this here, it will look like this for the students. Another trick I recently learned from a power teacher in Canada is how to turn a PDF of an exam into an auto-marked exam without typing anything. Sound too good to be true? Well, what she does is she takes a screenshot of each individual question and each answer that goes with it. On the Mac, you can do this easily by selecting Command-Shift-4. On a PC, you may need special screenshot software. Let me show you. Here I have a PDF of a math test. These questions would be time-consuming for me to write in Exam.net, so I take a screenshot of a question like this, and individual screenshots of each answer like this. Now I create an auto-marked exam. Choose a question type. In this case, my first question was a multiple choice question. Then for the question, I click this icon to add a graphic. And for each answer, I click this icon to add a screenshot for each answer option. Now, when I preview, it looks like this. While this can save a lot of time, the downside, of course, is that if I have any students that need text-to-speech or translation help, for example, the tools won't work since each question is a graphic rather than text. The next thing I want to show you is how you can prevent unauthorized people from accessing an exam. There is no added security risk if an unapproved person enters the exam, but you may not want students from other classes to view the questions in case they have a similar test later that day. To prevent unauthorized access, go to the Student Information section where you create the exam. There, next to the email option, you're able to insert a list of allowable email addresses. Then, only students who provide an email address on this list will be allowed in. The next power user tip is a trick for how to share an exam through an administrator. As you may know, in Exam.net, each school can have one or more school administrators. You can see who is an administrator at your school by looking for this icon in the list of teachers in the My School tab. A school administrator can appoint additional administrators, so there can be several people with this role. Now, as you probably know, you can share an exam with another teacher, but that teacher cannot share the exam further. But if you share an exam with a school administrator, that person can share it with other teachers. This can be a lifesaver if you're all set up to conduct an important exam with your class, but for some reason you're not able to be there yourself. The administrator can then share your exam with a colleague or an exam invigilator or proctor who can then cover for you. Now I want to show you a few tips to do with exams that have already been submitted. If you look under the Profile tab, there is information about you and your account at exam.net, and then at the bottom, you find two options that can be really useful. Firstly, if you accidentally delete a student or an exam, the trash can be a real lifesaver. Clicking here, you can view and restore all students or exams which were deleted during the past 20 days. Above the trash can, you find a button that shows you a list of the most recently handed in exams. This can be really useful if you conduct an exam or assignment that your students are able to do at a time of their choice. And by using this function, you avoid having to scan through each student in the monitoring view to see who has submitted. One last thing I want to show you is how you can restore exams from the archive. As a rule, an exam is automatically placed in the archive 180 days after it was created. Let's say you want to use an exam from your archive with a new class. All you have to do is click the three dots next to that exam, and in this menu you can select Delete Answers and Unarchive. Note that once you've done this, it is not possible to retrieve the student data attached to that exam in accordance with our privacy policy. That's all from me. I'll see you in another video.